Hello students, in this lecture I will discuss rabies test. And before starting rabies test, first I am discussing what is second comparison test. We have already discussed first comparison test, so first I will discuss second comparison test. So the statement is, if summation UN and summation VN be two series of positive terms, then summation UN will be convergent when summation VN is convergent. If after some particular term UN by UN minus 1 is less than VN by VN minus 1. Also summation UN will be divergent when summation VN is divergent if after some particular term UN by UN minus 1 is greater than VN by VN minus 1. So this is the statement. You have to just remember this statement. We will use this statement in the proof of rabies test. So what is rabies test? This is very very important proof as well as the numerical. So just learn the statement carefully. Let summation UN be the series of positive terms and let limit n tending to infinity bracket n bracket UN by UN plus 1 minus 1 bracket close curly bracket close is equal to L. Then summation UN is first convergent if L is greater than 1, second divergent if L is less than 1, and third test fails if L is equal to 1. So the given series summation UN can also be written as U1 plus U2 plus U3 plus dot 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 plus UN plus dot 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 up to infinity. And let us consider the auxiliary series summation VN be summation 1 by N to the power P, the P series. Then VN is 1 by N to the power P. Replacing N by N plus 1, we will get VN plus 1 is equal to 1 by N plus 1 to the power P. And by P series, we know that summation VN is convergent if P is greater than 1 and is divergent if P is less than equal to 1. This is less than equal to 1. P is less than and equal to 1. So, hence by second comparison test, the given series summation UN is convergent or divergent according as UN by UN plus 1 is greater than or less than VN by VN plus 1. We are using second comparison test. So this implies UN by UN plus 1 is greater or less than N plus 1 by N to the power P. Substituting the value of VN and VN plus 1, we will get N plus 1 by N to the power P. So right hand side can further be written as 1 plus 1 by n to the power p. So this implies un by un plus 1 is greater or less than 1 plus 1 by n to the power p. This implies un by un plus 1 is greater or less than, expanding this by using binomial theorem, we will get 1 plus p into 1 by n plus p minus 1 by factorial 2 into 1 by n square plus dot dot dot, the last term is 1 by n to the power p. So shifting this plus 1 to the left hand side, we will get un by un plus 1 minus 1 is greater or less than, and taking 1 by n common, we will get 1 by n bracket p plus p into p minus 1 by factorial 2 into 1 by n plus 1, the last term is 1 by n to the power p minus 1. Now shifting this 1 by n to the left hand side, we will get n un by un plus 1 minus 1 is greater or less than p plus p into p minus 1 by factorial 2 into 1 by n plus dot 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 plus 1 by n to the power p minus 1. Now taking limit as n tending to infinity both sides, we will get limit n tending to infinity n un by un plus 1 minus 1 is greater or less than p. And convergent or divergent of the series summation Vn depends upon P, and this is convergent if P is greater than 1 and divergent if P is less equal to 1. So using this we can further write as limit n tending to infinity n un by un plus 1 minus 1 is greater or less than 1. Hence summation un is convergent or divergent according as limit n tending to infinity n un by un plus 1 minus 1 is greater than 1 or less than 1. If it is greater than 1, the series is convergent, and if the limit n tending to infinity n un by un plus 1 minus 1 is less than 1, the given series is divergent and test fails if l is equal to 1. So come to an example. Test the convergence of the series for which un is equal to 2 square, 4 square, 6 square, dot dot dot, 2n minus 2 whole square, divided by 3 into 4 into 5, dot dot dot, 2n minus 2 by into 2n minus 1 into x to the power 2n. So in solution, we will take un as 2 square, 4 square, 6 square, dot dot dot, 2n minus 2 whole square, divided by 3 into 4 into 5, dot dot dot, 2n minus 2 into 2n minus 1 into x to the power 2n. Replacing n by n plus 1, we will get un plus 1 as 2 square into 4 square into 6 square, dot dot dot, 2n minus 2 whole square into 2n square. In the last value, 2n minus 2 whole square, replace n by n plus 1, you will get 2n square. And since this is a series, you have to write 2n minus 2 whole square also. Similarly, in denominator, first write till 3 into 4 into 5 dot dot dot, 2n minus 2 into 2n minus 1. Then in 2n minus 2, if you replace n by n plus 1, you will get 2n. And in 2n minus 1, if you replace n by n plus 1, you will get 2n plus 1. And x to the power 2n by replacing n by n plus 1 becomes x to the power 2n plus 2. So now dividing un by un plus 1, we will get un by un plus 1 is equal to 2 square, 4 square, 6 square, dot dot dot, 2n minus 2 whole square, divided by 3 into 4 into 5, dot dot dot, 2n minus 2 into 2n minus 1 into 3 into 4 into 5, dot dot dot, 2n minus 2 into 2n minus 1 into 2n into 2n plus 1, divided by 2 square, 4 square, 6 square, dot dot dot, 2n minus 2 whole square into 2n square, and into x to the power 2n by x to the power 2n plus 1, after cancel out the common terms like 2 square, 4 square, 6 square, 2n minus 2 square is cancelled from numerator and denominator. Similarly, 3, 4, 5, 2n minus 2 and 2n minus 1 is cancelled out from the numerator and denominator. So we are left with 2n into 2n plus 1 by 2n plus 1 by 2n whole square into 1 by x square. So if we take limit as n tending to infinity both side, we will get limit n tending to infinity un by un plus 1 equal to limit n tending to infinity. Just simplifying this, if we take 2n common from this term also, we will get 2n whole square, which is cancelled out from numerator and denominator, and we are left with 1 plus 1 by 2n into 1 by x square. So after substituting limit as n tending to infinity, we are just left with 1 by x square. So by D'Alembert's ratio test, the given series is convergent if 1 by x square is greater than 1, or x square is less than 1, or x is less than 1. And the series is divergent if 1 by x square is less than 1, or x square is greater than 1, or x is greater than 1. And the test fails if 1 by x square is equal to 1, or x square equal to 1. So if we take x square is equal to 1, here if x square is equal to 1, we are left with un by un plus 1 is equal to 2n plus 1 by 2n. So if D'Alembert's ratio test fails, then we will apply Rabi's test. So you have to remember the form of Rabi's test. It is n un by un plus 1 minus 1. So first we will get the value of un by un plus 1 minus 1. So this is equal to 2n plus 1 by 2n minus 1. After simplifying, we are left with 1 by 2n. So next, the form of Rabi's test is n into un by un plus 1 minus 1. So if we multiplied the right hand side by n, we are left with 1 by 2. So if we take now limit as n tending to infinity, n un by un plus 1 minus 1, we will get the value as 1 by 2, which is less than 1. So by Rabi's test, summation un is divergent when x square is equal to 1 or x is equal to 1. So previous we have seen that the given series is convergent when x is less than 1 and it is divergent when x is greater than 1. And when x is equal to 1, the series is also divergent. So combining all these statements, we just write summation un is convergent when x is less than 1 and divergent when x is greater equal to 1. So this is very, very important test for the syllabus. So practice more questions from your book and simplify this.